A good deal is made of the fact that for the last 14 or 15 years of his life, Rembrandt faced financial ruin. And some people claim that his reputation plummeted too, but that isn't true. But there's no doubt that his life was relatively hard compared to how it had been in the previous two or three decades. But I think what emerges from looking at his art is how, as an old man, he transcends the mundaneness of everyday life. And on a personal level, for me, it's nowhere more powerfully expressed than in this painting. This is called The Flayed Ox. It's painted in 1655, the year, in fact, that he's forced to sell off his house and a lot of his studio contents. And in some ways, on a superficial level, it looks as if the old man is taking his revenge on the world at large and on humanity by the savage and brutal way with which he depicts the carcass of this ox. But look again. As always with Rembrandt, if you scratch beneath the skin or the surface, much more is happening. There's a young servant girl peering round a door, looking at this rotting carcass, and the symbolism is clear, isn't it? Young life meets aging, putrid death. And sometimes when I look at this painting, it does almost seem to stink. But I think it's wonderfully ambiguous too, and that when I look at it on other occasions, there's a freshness, almost as if Rembrandt has managed to beat some life back into this ailing or dead corpse. And then you look at the way he's painted the corpse itself, and it's as if he's transformed his brush into a butcher's knife or machete. And he's hacked and prodded and pared and gouged at the carcass. And then on other occasions it looks like he's wallowed in it or smoothed it. It looks like a martyr sometimes, or some human corpse that's had horrendous torture done to it, suspended on an almost cross-like structure. And it seems to me that Rembrandt's career has come back, or almost come round, full circle. Think of the anatomy lesson of Dr. Tulp. Rembrandt, the young, curious individual, in a relatively detached way, painting the dissection and observing what a corpse is like from the inside. Here, though, this is pure physical expression. And so, in the last phase of Rembrandt's life and career, what we see is him wrestling explicitly with the big questions. Mortality, life and death, and the confrontation of death, and the fact this stuff of which Rembrandt is made and we're all made, flesh and bone, eventually will decay and rot.